Spirit in here now. Somebody better get a shout on, because you don't know what tomorrow is going to hold. Somebody pray. Glory.
Agape, agape, In other words, they are going backwards. Acts chapter 17, verse 23. Acts chapter 17, verse 23. What it said, Jesse?
For as I passed by,
Paul said, for as I was walking by
and beheld your devotions,
I looked at what you were devoted to.
I found an altar with this inscription.
And as I was looking, I found where you bow down, where you worship, and I found this description or inscription wrote there.
To the unknown God.
What was written there was to the unknown God. Read.
Whom therefore ye ignorantly worship him, declare I unto you.
And because you don't know who God is, by ignorant, you are worshiping him and don't know it. Ain't that something? But you have made known your devotion was to an unknown God. And they that worship him must worship him in spirit and in truth. And we'll read, we're going to go back to the scripture and show you that the Spirit of God reveals everything there is to be revealed about God. And the reason you don't know it is because you really don't know God. The reason for our subject today is I was questioning God about the church. Why is it that a lot of folks seem to put other things ahead of God? Why is it that they will get their money and buy things that they want, like even, don't y'all get mad at me, weeds on your head. I just like to say that, you know, I use that quite often. And false eyelashes and false nails and whatever makes you look good, you know. I'm not against those things. Get me straight now. I'm not against what I'm saying, but when we do those things first, before we do the things of God, that's what I'm worried about. Y'all got to hear me. Amen. Don't get mad, but just hear me. And so I was questioning God about, why is it when I thought about the church, how it were years ago, particularly when I first got saved, folk was faithful, members was faithful, those that claimed to be saved, those that claimed to be filled with the Holy Ghost, you didn't have to worry about whether they was coming to church. They did not have to wait for somebody to knock on their door and say, you need to come to church. They automatically came. I'm talking from experience. I went to church when I got saved because I wanted to go. I came because I felt like that's where I wanted to be. There was other things that I was enjoying in life, but after I got saved, I enjoyed church better. More than anything else. But down through the years, can you agree with me, that seemed like that desire has slipped away from you? You might not want to admit it, but most of you rather not be at church. Even though you ain't got too much at home. But a television and some ice cube in the refrigerator or something like that. And some water, but you'd rather be there drinking your water, watching the television, than to be at church. You'll be surprised how our spirit changes when we say we're having church. Amen. So I asked God, why is it that folks have done that? I thought of scripture that said, well, you know, the Lord said that in the last days there will be a great falling away. We make all kinds of excuses like the Bible says that was going to happen. But the Bible actually tells us that in the last day, folk really will come are in the church that are falling out. Right. But I want you to know there are unsaved people out there in trouble. They are looking to come in. The harvest is ripe, but the laborers are few. There are folk that want to stop and get out of the mess that they are in. But the church folk is so messed up that they don't even know how to go pick the fruit. They go out there with a hammer trying to beat them in the head when you the one need to be beat. He's talking to a bunch of people that was pagans, that worshiped idol God, that made idol God, that was trying to find God through things, trying to find God through things that they themselves came up with, their idea of God. There are many of you that are sitting here today got your own idea who God is and how he is. Do I have any witness? Your thoughts is this is what God is like. We got nervous even to say that God won't say this and God won't do that and God ain't there and God ain't in that. And you don't know because you don't know God. Amen. So Paul passed by and seen these pagans. They was trying to find God. When people make things to try to get some help from, they are actually trying to find God. Yeah. They're trying to find a release or find something better than what they already have. I wish I could preach right. Amen. You know, there are people, you never stop to ask people the question, why is it that they drink and get drunk? We always condemn them. You don't ask, why do they go out and go to bars? You have not asked, why is they so mixed up on people, man going with a man and a woman with a woman? You ain't asked them, why are they like that? All we do is condemn. The fact is, those people are looking, seeking for something better than what they have or what they have had. And because we have fallen short of being there to witness, to support, and to guide them, they come up with their own ditty or their own ideal. What God will accept and what God will allow. So they try to create something to help them. Can I get me a witness here? So it is like an unknown God. It is something that does not exist. But in their mind, these things actually exist. Amen. They are trying to get something to help them to go through life in a good way. And when they find something that satisfies their flesh, they feel like you don't understand because you don't know like I know what I've been through. And you don't know how good they is to me or how good it is to me. Therefore, I got to do what is best for me. And you can't tell me nothing because when I look at your raggedy life and I have discovered you ain't no better than me because you curse more than I do. And if the truth be told, I know you slip more than I do. And you are sneaking, drinking, think I don't know it. And you are leaking.
legally married, but you ain't with the one you want to be with. But because I am in the church, that have to be my secret. Y'all don't like me today. And therefore, your devotion to God is not what it ought to be. And that's why you seek things and put other things above God, because look like God or this God thing just ain't working out. Because you've been going to church and you ain't no better than me. At least I got a job. You talking about me like a dog, but you don't refuse to ask me for an offering. Y'all better leave me alone here today. So I got myself a God, but he's unknown to you. But that's not God. I tell you this one thing, I got enough sense to know when you love something, you hang with it. I got enough sense to know if you love something, you want to be around it. You can't say you love me and always leaving me. Hallelujah. When I was cold, I always want to be with my baby. Anybody else ever know been cold and know that's right? When I went to sleep at night, I dreamed about my baby. I couldn't hardly stand to be absent from her. Luther, I couldn't hardly wait till I see her again. But now you call yourself in love and go away, stay away, miss Wednesday night, miss Sunday school. How about you in love with God? You ain't fooling nobody. Oh, I love the Lord. You don't love no God when you're staying away from what he got planned for you. What it look like the lady fix you a candlelight dinner and you don't show up? Women, how you feel if your man don't show up? Risa, thank you for being honest. Some of y'all are like it don't matter to you, but I know it's matter to you. Amen. You prepare meal, cook it, made it special. Sprinkle a little rose on the floor. Spray a little perfume in the air. Sit back and practice before he come. And then he say, oh, in a minute, he coming through the door. 2 minutes late, he ain't show. 5 minutes, you're getting a little uneasy. You called and you said, I'm on my way. Yeah. Hour later, he ain't show. You know something is wrong. You walk by the kennel like and want to kick it over. The food in the stove.
lies, our history starts when we were sold. One of the lies taught us every day. When we went to school, black history had no place. What are the lies? How long must this last? I'll tell you the truth.
If you would like to know more about your heritage, please stop by the Cosby Educational Heritage Center in the OC Hill Neighborhood Center at 445 Bowman Street. For appointments, please call us at 419-775-8834 or 419-571-4627. And always remember, education is the key.